Alright guys, welcome back to another MCreator procedure tutorial. Today what we're going to be covering is if statements and the not block, and we'll be testing out how the conditions return if the conditions are true or false. So with the not block, we'll get into that in a little bit later, as it will play a huge part with the if statement. It will make a little bit more sense once we actually have some things going on. First off, the if statement, it can be found under the flow control, and then you have three default options here. You can customize these. I usually just go ahead and grab the basic one and then customize it to what I need it. Basically what this does, it allows you to test for a specific condition based on certain blocks. Now under a lot of these data tabs, these are basically conditions that you can usually put on them in certain circumstances. For example, logic will always work on an if statement itself. So when you're working with a lot of things like different values and stuff, you might need a logic block of some sort, which are listed under here. There's tons of different types. We'll get into those in a future video, especially when you're working with like numbers and stuff like that. The numbers won't directly go on to the if statement, but you can use a logic number block to basically do a test with. With the customization, if you click on the gear icon, there's a little gear icon in darker blue here. You can actually customize how the procedure is going to run. A condition will always return either true or false. So if the condition is going to run true, then so whatever's in the do section, it will basically run that script. When you have if else statement, this will test if the first condition is true. If that condition is false, then it will move on to the next if else statement. That if else statement is false, then it will move on to whatever is after that. What will happen is it will keep trying to find one that is true, and then if it runs that, then it will cancel out the ones that are below. If we had first condition failed, second condition returned true, parts below that else if statement will always be canceled out, as it doesn't need to go any further. When you have a else statement at the end, basically when all the other conditions return false, what will happen is this one will always return true. For example, a lot of script that might test for very specific things, like maybe the time of day is 600 or something like that, like maybe 6 a.m., 7 a.m., and then you want to run something for all the other times that are not in those conditions, and you can always use an else statement. So hopefully that makes a little bit sense of how that works. We'll be testing out these in just a little bit. The other thing that we have is a not block. So this block is actually very unique. It will returns true if the input is false, returns false if the input is true. In this case, if we had a variable that returns true, we're going to test if it is actually false. Basically switches the opposite of that variable or condition to the opposite side of it. So let's go ahead and print out some values based on this. I'm going to create a very simple local variable, just a logic or string, probably go with a string so we can test for a little bit more. So let's go ahead and test, we'll just say name, and we can go ahead and work with that. So we're going to test if that variable, first we're going to need to set that variable name. So I'm going to just quickly assign some text to that name, and we're going to go maybe Bob. We just wanted to know how basically the procedure works. We can always test it later on with a different value. So we're going to test if the string value equals something. So I'm going to go under logic, grab a simple string block, place that in there, and then we're testing if whatever variable this is assigned to, or the value that it's assigned to, we're testing if that is going to be something. So if it is not Bob, then this should run, because basically we want to run if this name is not Bob. So we can go ahead and then test maybe if the name is Bob, and then have it run something. So basically if this is true, then this will run. So if the name equals Bob, so this will always run in this case. And then for the one up here, this will only run if the name is something different. Right now we're not going to worry about the if statement, because in this case we only have a true or false system going on, so we don't really need an else statement in this case. So let's go ahead and just print out something like this is not Bob, is not Bob, and then we'll test if this is Bob. this is Bob. So let's go ahead and save that. When we right click on a block, it should print out the this is Bob message. We're going to right click on any block and it says right here that this is Bob. So we know that this is going to be running our condition down here. So this is the this is Bob. So the first condition basically failed because this is because it is set to Bob. So in this case, we're testing if the value is false. So Bob is not true. So in the other case, we are testing if Bob is true. So let's go ahead and change this to Dave and we'll see if Dave will run. We'll go ahead and save this and then we'll go ahead and boot this up again and then give it another try. All right, so let's go ahead and clear console again just to see what's going on. And we'll go ahead and click on it. And it says this is not Bob because it is actually Dave. So we can see that Dave is the value that we have set. So this is basically testing if the value is not Bob. So we're going to say this is not Bob. So that's basically how conditions work and the breakdown of not blocks. Of course, there's tons of more things that we can cover just based on this, like the operators and how they all work and stuff like that. We will get to that in the future. Right now, I just wanted to cover the if statements as there's a lot of uses for this. And I use these like almost in every procedure tutorial that I've covered. So we will need this in order to move on, especially when we're working with the not block, which we'll be going into how to run things on server or client side. So we'll need that block in order to demonstrate that, which is why I basically covered these two particular things in today's video. So the assignment for today is very simple. I want to see if you guys can figure out how to put together a if statement, one with the if, else if, and else condition without using the flow control for these ones, and also make a procedure that can return something in the middle. So if it can return else if, so make sure that you have two conditions and that the second one will always return true. The other thing that I want you to do is to somehow incorporate the not block into that procedure. So that will be your assignment for this week. If you have any questions, you can also come onto my Discord and ask them in the help channel, and I will be happy to help you, or somebody in the community can help you if I'm not available. Outside of that, don't forget to subscribe, comment down below, rate the video, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Peace out.